back to the hot topics. A mother and daughter who are not doctors and have no medical training whatsoever are headed to the big house after botching a woman's BBL that ultimately led to her death. Now, the woman received three separate procedures and died immediately after the third one. She told friends she was having surgeries because she wanted to work in the adult film industry. Now, the chemicals used during her surgery are not intended to be used on humans and can attack the heart, the brain, and the kidneys. Our thoughts and prayers go out to her family. Now, let's take a look at the photos of this mother and daughter duo. And would you guys trust them to do a BBL on you?
Oh, hell. Oh, oh.
It's giving me very Lord of the Rings,
Planet of the Apes, just
very don't do my surgery.
Yeah,
the surgery was,
you know,
bad.
Here's the thing for me. For me, the real story here is not even the botched BBLs, the backroom BBLs, because the trans people have been doing it at the back of the Holiday Inn, and women and some of you celebrities have been getting it. This is a story of what came first, the chicken or the egg. This is definitely a crime of opportunity, and these people only exist because the insecurities of women and their bodies exist. I think that is the problem, and that's the conversation moving forward that we need to be having 2021 forward. Why is it that women feel the pressure to have extreme body modifications in order to feel and look beautiful? For me, that's the real conversation that needs to be had. People gonna always commit crimes when there's an opportunity. So for me, this is really a non-story.
Okay. You want to answer, Al, or do you want me to go? You want me to go?
No, what were you gonna say?
I was gonna say, as a woman, I'll tell you what I feel. It's again, like you said, kind of like what came first, the chicken or the egg? You know what I mean? Like, is it with the women feeling like it left out because the women that do have that, or the trans women that have that, they get revered, they get praised. So you're like, I need that. You know what I mean? I don't know. Luckily, I focus on other things. I don't care about that kind of stuff. But it's a trend. It's so common. People that before was people in the community, right? Then you saw people in hip hop, and now you see it so mainstream. You see people that have nothing to do with the entertainment business, just a soccer mom walking around with this big flesh colored diaper on, looking ridiculous. Mm-hmm. And the BBLs, I looked at the most dangerous and risky surgery. That's the surgery that most people die in. They say 1 in 3,000 people that get those surgeries die. That's a pretty large number, I would think. Yep. You know, yeah. Al, what do you think about this surgery?
It probably has to do with a lot of them getting them as well. Go ahead, Al.
You know, I agree with both of you on this one, but I think in this particular case, as I read more on the story and I read the police report, this is where this case gets interesting. The paramedics who picked her up, right? Because the two women that you saw in the picture abandoned the house after they called 911. But when the paramedics arrived, right, and they took the young lady to the emergency room, she was still alive. So what happened was, when she got to the emergency room, there were attending doctors, which are basically physicians that are in medical school. They left her unattended because allegedly the paramedics did not inform the doctors that there was actually complications because of silicone injections. So she actually died in the emergency room because she was unattended.
Well, we're not going to say because she was unattended. I mean,
because she had the
subsequently unattended as a result of.
You could have probably had someone told them what the deal was. They would
they
have
been probably did something,
a clot or something, and they would have administered, or they would have followed a different protocol. Is all I'm saying.
I just want to point out. Go ahead, Claudia.
No, you go ahead.
I want to point out one thing that's fascinating, how trends in fashion change. When I was in college between the years of 2001 and 2005 at Florida State, it's predominantly white school, a lot of the white girls had the flat booties, and that's when Abercrombie and Fitch skirts and Aeropostale and all that was popular. That's what we wore back then. And I will never forget a white guy and a white girl. We were talking in student government, and the white guy was saying that girls with big butts in their culture, they consider it fat. Because we were laughing at this white girl because she had this white denim skirt on and her ass looked like a piece of plywood. And they were like, that's how we like it. Like, they consider curves to be fat. And it's just so funny how things have changed. Granted, the woman that died was a Hispanic descent, but I even see white women now at the gym with these big old booties. So it's just fascinating to me how they went from honoring and celebrating big, big boobs and flat ass to now wanting the ass.
Well, so I'll tell you why. It's because it's more acceptable to be with black men. All these women a lot of the women that are doing this are attracted to black men. So guess what they do? They don't have the curvy butt. They get it injected.
Here's the money for this or that or, you know, whatever. But
back in the Kim, when she first, I remember white men saying that she was fat. And I'm like, she's not fat. She's curvy. And they thought that was like a ill thing, not like a desire thing. So it's more of these white women are getting black D. So they're going to get the booties to get those black men. Right, Al? What you think?
There's just so many aspects to this because, you know, the strippers with the booties, I just think people want the attention of having a fat ass. I mean, I just feel like that now is the it thing. Like, I don't know. Because I mean, I'm like, I remember when I was coming through college, and I don't want to tell my age, you know, the women who had the bigger breasts are the women who got more attention. Like, you know, especially in the, you know, my white friends, white male friends, they always were after the women with the big breasts. And now it's just the opposite. Now they want to see a woman with some ass.
So Al, you got the biggest ass out of three of us. So what's the attention you do? Like your butt, and it sits high.
It's
so
how's real high?
And I know this is gonna happen. Well, as you guys have seen from hanging out with me, I luckily don't get a lot of attention from having a high booty.
To hell you
tell. Lies you tell. Lies.
You know, we're stopping all that traffic on Collins Avenue, baby, outside the Faena. But we're gonna say that for our memoir, Claudia.
Right. I remember that button, that them pants, them slacks with the booty, this is high. Okay.